Yes, hope you are all fit and fine. I think you have watched, enjoyed and got an idea about our previous video. It's time to check your answers. I believe that you have done all the allotted work in a better way. Tick the correct answers. Alexander asked his generals to remove the chains of Puru because he did not like a brave man like Puru in chains. Puru did not accept Alexander's proposal to be a vassal because he was very brave and patriotic. Alexander made friends with Puru because Alexander liked Puru's bravery and self-respect. Alexander was really great because he defeated Puru, set him free, respected him, and made friends with him. Pick out the antonyms from the text for the words given below. Victory, defeat, timid, brave, humble, proud, accept, refuse, dependent, independent. Fill in the blanks in the following paragraph with the words given in the box. I know that you are very skillful and worthy of the position you hold, but I am really amazed to know that you feel as though you have conquered the world. These days nobody is being frightened by the other. I would like to make a proposal so that you will remain humble and lawful. I hope my words capture your imagination and respect me as your teacher. Now fill in the blanks in the following paragraph with should or must. I should say that you must come to school regularly because you cannot miss important lessons. You must attend extra classes in time tomorrow. Otherwise, I'll punish you. You must return my book which I gave you a month ago. You should change your habits, otherwise you will not come up in life. Now read the conversation between a doctor and a patient and fill in the blanks with should and must. Doctor, Mr. Rao, what exactly is your problem? Patient, I have been suffering from gastric problem for a long time. Doctor, Mr. Rao, I should say you must not eat non-vegetarian or spicy food for some time. Patient, can I eat boiled eggs or omelets, doctor? Doctor, isn't a non-vegetarian? You must not eat any non-vegetarian food for quite some time. In fact, you should have stopped eating it long ago. You must consult me in a week. Patient, I am sorry, doctor. I won't eat non-vegetarian food any longer. You are quite correct, doctor. I must take your advice and should avoid eating non-vegetarian and spicy food. Thank you very much, doctor. Doctor, you are welcome. I think you should remember my advice. Writing. Given below are some jumbled sentences. Rearrange them in the right order and write a meaningful paragraph by using appropriate connectives. Okay, now I am going to read out the correct numbering of the sentences, children. First one, just I am reading out the numbers. 10, 2, 1, 6, 9, 5, 7, 11, 3, 12, 4, 8. So, I think you have followed the correct order to write a meaningful paragraph by using the connectives, conjunctions. Study skills. Here they have given you words and asking you to decide or to know whether the given word is a noun, verb, adjective. Some may be three, some are two. Chain. Noun, verb. Conquer, verb. Fight, noun, verb. Like, noun, verb, adjective. Refuse, noun, verb. Reject, noun, verb. Respect, noun, verb. Talk, noun, verb. Treat, noun, verb. Only like is adjective, children. Like is noun, verb, adjective. Like battle. Except these two words, rest of the other words are noun and verb. Writing skills, children. Diary entry in our previous class also we have learnt about this in 6th class, and again in this class also they have given you. Just we'll have a look about that diary entry. Many have the habit of writing diary, so it is very useful to us to recall our memories related to past. So some may be sad and some are very happy moments. So see here, but it is a very good habit of writing diary. A diary is a personal book in which one records day-to-day events. So it is our personal book and we record our day-to-day events in that diary. Often a diary is kept by the writer to record his or her own experiences and feelings. So it is maintained by the writer. The person who writes his diary or her diary is known as writer, to write their own experiences and their feelings also. So here they have given some of the tips or hints which help us to write the diary in a better way, or to maintain our diary in a better way. A diary entry must always include the date on which the entry is made. So on which day you are writing the diary, the date should be there. It can be a few sentences or a few pages. It depends upon the wish of a writer. You can write only few sentences or you may write pages also. As it is a personal and informal piece of writing, there are no set rules about how it should be written. So as it is personal and moreover informal, standard rules and regulations are not there to follow. A diary entry should include a mix of facts and feelings. So it should be related to facts and feelings. Remember, you may want to read your diary many years from now when you might have forgotten the events and people you have written about. By this, what should you understand? After many years, if you read also, you should be able to understand your diary. So you have to write it in a very clear way. So do not use abbreviations unless they are explained on first appearance. Don't use shortcuts or abbreviations unless you maintain them as they maintain in the dictionary. As how do they give the full forms for abbreviations in the dictionary, in the same way if you also maintain or written the first page of your diary, then you can follow, or else better do not follow. Similarly, it is a good idea to write the full names of the people you mention. Always write the complete name of the people about whom you are writing, at least the first time you mention them. Be truthful, because years later you will not know which are true memories and which are not. Be truthful, write truthfully, okay? Don't write false statements. So here they have given format of diary entry, children: day, date, year, time. So dear diary, salutation, it is optional. Beginning of entry, refer to events and feelings. Resolution or conclusion. So see here, they have given sample also. Imagine that you have saved a boy from a road accident. Everyone appreciated you. Now write a diary entry about the incident. So you have saved a boy from a road accident, and the people who has watched that incident, they have started appreciating you. Even you also felt very happy as you saved the life of a boy. Okay, as you saved a boy. And now what are they asking you? Imagine that you have saved a boy from a road accident. You have to imagine yourself that you have saved a boy from road accident, and you have to write a diary entry about that incident. So here you can observe the format: day, date, month, year, and below that time, and below that salutation, dear diary. Now you have started writing content. Refer to events and feelings. For the first time in my life, I feel proud of myself. I am very proudful by looking at me. I can't still believe that I did such a brave act that heroes do in movies or soldiers do on rare occasions. How heroes do or how soldiers do on rare occasions. While I was going to school on foot, suddenly I saw a child attempting to cross the road without anyone's help. So I have seen a child who is crossing the road without anyone's help. A speeding truck was about to hit the boy. The truck, which was coming very speedily, it is coming, the speeding truck. So from the truck I have saved that boy, but had a narrow escape since I immediately pulled him back. So I have reacted immediately and I have pulled him back. The boy I rescued was less than half of my age, but I still can't understand how he happened to cross the road without anyone to accompany him. So for example, you are 12 year old. So what did the boy tell here? He is telling half of my age. So he might be 6 year old, as you are going to write. Okay, so here what are they telling? I can't understand still now also, how did they leave such a kind of young boy in the road? So here what is he telling? I am very happy as I have saved that boy from the accident. With the help of a passerby, I took the boy to the police station and reported the incident. The police assured that they would inquire and send him to his parents. The police assured, they have guaranteed me, we'll hand over the child to their parents. You no need to bother about him. We are very proud of you. Responsible child, responsible child. My parents and all my teachers appreciated my deed, and my friends started adoring me. They have started following my footsteps. So in that manner, they have started treating me as a hero. From this I learned one truth: everyone can become a hero if he or she conquers fear, though risk is involved. So if we leave fear, we'll become a hero. So this is a specimen or an example, children, for making you to get an idea how to write a diary entry. Now see here, in the lesson Puru the Brave, you have read about the bravery of Puru and how he fought with Alexander. Now what should you do? Imagine that you are Alexander. Imagine yourself as your Alexander, think the king of Macedonia, and express your admiration, your likeliness for Puru in the form of a diary entry. So you have to follow the format and you have to imagine yourself as Alexander and write your admiration, means your likeliness for Puru, in the form of a diary entry. In your diary you have to write by imagining yourself as a Alexander. In the story The Magic of Silk, a girl called Suyami helps an old man and gets a gift of white beard, which it turns into a magical silk thread later. Now imagine that you are Suyami and write a diary entry expressing your wonder and gratitude in the given context. So related to second question, you have to imagine yourself as Suyami and you have to write a diary entry by, how should you write? That you are expressing your thankfulness or gratitude to the old man. So this lesson will be completed in your next video, children. After completion of watching that video, 20th video, you can answer second question. First complete writing for first question. Okay, notice making. We'll go through notice making also. A notice is a very short piece of writing written in a formal style. Diary entry is done in an informal way. Notice making is done in a formal style. The purpose of a notice is to announce or give information to a specific group of people about a specific event or happening. The events may include announcements, celebrations, inaugurations, sales, public instructions, appeals, etc. So notice is done in a formal way for making announcements, to let the information known to all. We write a notice and place it in the notice board. It is common to use the passive voice in notices. Which kind of voice is used in notices, children? Passive voice. In order to grab the attention of the readers, catchy and striking phrases or slogans can be used for the heading. So we use catchy and striking phrases and slogans also used for the heading. Standard abbreviations are allowed in notices. So what do they use, children? Standard abbreviations they use. They use standard abbreviations, full forms. A notice should be written in the following format. See here, they have given you proforma also. Notice heading should be the name of the person or organization or issuing the notice. Notice, heading of the notice, date, body of the notice. This should include only relevant ideas. Clearly mention the date, time and venue if necessary. Writer's signature, name, designation. A notice must inform the readers about the event or agenda, what is going to happen. This is the format, children. Once if we go through again one example, you will get an idea very clear. Objective, the purpose of the occasion, date and time, when it will take place, venue, where it will take place, who can attend or apply, specific instructions, contact person and address, the issuing authority. Now let us go through sample notice. The Residents Welfare Association, Maya Enclave, is organizing a health camp in the locality. As the secretary of the association, draft a notice informing the residents about the event. Give necessary details. So see here, Residents Welfare Association, Maya Enclave, notice, health camp, heading, date, month, year, body of the notice, day and date, time, venue, benefits, and whom they have to contact. These all details they have given here. Once if you go through these, you will get an idea. And see the next one, entirely different from first notice. Your Sneha, a student of class 7, you left your library book in the school canteen and cannot find it. Draft a notice to be put up on the notice, school notice board, giving details of the book and to whom it should be returned. So see here, so you left your library book in the school canteen and cannot find it. So what are you doing? So here they have kept a notice board. What did they keep? Let us go through. Greenfield School, North Extension, notice, lost. A library book was left in the school canteen during lunch break yesterday. The title of the book is All the King's Men. It is a hardbound book with a green binding. Anyone who finds the book may please return it to the senior librarian or undersigned. So, your Sneha, you have to imagine yourself as Sneha. So, you have lost your book and you have kept a notice related to that in the notice board. On the notice board you kept. To whom you have to hand over also, you have mentioned details. Once go through these two notices, children, you will get an idea how to write the notice. And you have to answer these questions also. You have to keep the material beside the device. Then you will not get any sort of doubts at the time of watching the video. So your school is organizing a children fair on Teacher's Day. As the school prefect, write a notice to inform students about the school fair and how they can participate in it. Second question, your school is organizing a tour to Agra for class 7 during the winter vacation. During the winter vacation, as Juhi or Jai, you have to imagine yourself as Juhi or Jai. You have to write with that name only. Head girl or boy, write a notice to inform the class 7 students about it. Now passage exercises, children, you have to go through this and answer these questions. Even this also. These all passage exercises there in your material. Go through those carefully and answer the questions without mistakes. Now see, home they brought her warrior dead. The poet of this poem is Alfred Lord Tennyson. Four stanzas are there in this poem, children. Home they brought her warrior dead. She nor swooned nor uttered a cry. All her maidens watching said, she must weep or she will die. Then they praised him soft and low, called him worthy to be loved, truest friend and noblest foe, yet she neither spoke nor moved. Stole a maiden from her place, lightly to the warrior's step, took the face cloth from the face, yet she neither moved nor wept. Rose, a nurse of 90 years, set his child upon her knee. Like summer tempest came her tears. Sweet my child, I live for thee. See, children, home they brought her warrior dead. By this, what can you understand here? Warrior, a soldier good at fighting. That warrior was dead in warfare. So they have brought that dead warrior to the home. So who is referred to her here? Her refers to warrior's wife. She nor swooned nor uttered a cry. She did not become unconscious, and at the same time she did not cry also. All her maidens means who, children? Servants, watching, they were seeing what's going on there. And what did they tell? She must weep or she will die. She has to cry at any cost or she will die. She will not be there. Then they prized him soft and low, called him worthy to be loved, truest friend and noblest foe. Yet she neither spoke nor moved. Who refers to they here? Maiden started appreciating him very softly with a low voice. Called him worthy to be loved. So he is very valuable person to be loved. Truest friend, very good friend, and noblest foe, greatest enemy. And she neither spoke nor moved. Even though maidens continuously appreciating him, she did not speak and no movement at all in her. Stole a maiden from her place. So slowly a servant came very near to her place. Lightly to the warrior stepped. She came, that servant means maid, came very nearer to the warrior, dead warrior. Took the face cloth from the face. So here, from whose face? From the dead warrior's face cloth she has taken. So she has moved the cloth a little bit. So that warrior's face will be visible to her. You can see in the picture also. And she neither moved nor wept, even though then also she did not move and she did not cry also. Rose, a nurse of 90 years. There is a nurse, you can observe, an old lady also in the picture. She stood, set his child upon her knee. Whose child? So warrior has a child. So nurse kept that child in warrior's wife's knees, means in her lap. Like summer tempest, storm in the ocean, came her tears. Then she started crying by looking at the child. My sweet child, sweet my child, I live for you. Hope you have understood the poem, children. Watch the video, complete the allotted exercises. You have to do the work very regularly. Stay home, stay safe, follow the precautions to avoid corona.